this video from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're gonna take a look at a newer knife from Viper Knives out of Maniago, Italy. Viper is one of these higher-end Italian knife makers like Lion Steel, Fox Knives, MKM, and knife makers like that. But I think Viper Knives has a very great selection of collaborations with very well-known makers. You may have seen my review of the Viper Knives Key, which is a collaboration between Viper Knives and Jesper Voxner, is one of the highest regarded knife makers. It does a lot of collaborations with different companies. Here you can see his logo, and this was, in my opinion, a pretty much home run piece. I will leave that here at the top for you to admire. But today we're looking at a locking folder from Viper Knives that was new in 2019, but I couldn't get around to taking a look at one and get one in my hands to show off to you guys. And it's also going to be a Jesper Voxner's design. You know, I'm a big Jesper Voxner's fan, had and have a lot of his designs in my collection, and also think that his design language and his designs are very, very useful and very good looking, and also extremely ergonomic. So today we have here the Viper Knives Bologne, which is named after a fish, a gar fish to be exact. So a very nice and slender fish that also is a fish of prey, so he actually hunts other fishes to eat, if I'm not mistaken. And you can certainly feel a Nautic overall theme here in this knife. Very long and slender, really looks like a kind of slender fish, so great naming there. And let's start off by telling you the stats here of the Viper Bologne. So we have an overall length of 7.9 inches or about 20 centimeters. We have a cutting edge of 3.35 inches or 8.5 centimeters, a blade stock of 3.5 millimeters. The steel is M390 out of Austria, so very high-end steel, same steel used here on the Viper Key at the top. Then we have a hand length of 4.55 inches or 11.5 centimeters and a very lightweight overall weight of 80 grams or 2.8 ounces. So very nice, slender, lightweight knife with a very high-end construction. You have heard M390 steel on the blade with a nice satin finish that you can see here. And then we have a titanium construction. I would call it a titanium frame lock with carbon fiber overlays, also because we have parts of the titanium construction revealed by a little bit smaller overlays of carbon fiber. And this is actually the bronze anodized version. You can see that here, they have nicely bronze anodized and tumbled titanium parts. And over that, we have a great real carbon fiber overlay. You can see that here, all the layers of the carbon fiber. And on top, we have the standard kind of carbon fiber weave texture. So no shred carbon fiber or anything like that. It's a nice standard kind of carbon fiber weave. And we can see a bunch of different places where you can see the anodized bronze titanium shining through. We have the holes here in the back. We have the cutaway at the bottom as well as at the top, where you can see these nicely chamfered titanium liners. And as I said before, we have the liner or frame lock, depending on how you want to call it. But it is, these are pretty thick liners if you call it a liner lock. We also have a titanium backspacer, has some jimping on it, and then we have a bent titanium pocket clip with a screw affixed from the back right there. So this is actually swappable for left to right side use. And we also have a lanyard hole that will go through here, so you can use a smaller kind of lanyard if you want to do so. Everything runs on captured ball bearings and has a very nice and overall smooth action. We have a rounded spine like you see from a lot of these higher end Italian makers. I think that's a really nice touch, especially with the slightly forward jimping. You see this also on a lot of different Jesper Voxner's and now also Giant Mouse design knives, where you have the jimping not where you would expect it. You have it slightly forward, but in this knife, it's really where your thumb wants to land. You can also do a slight foregrip, use the integrated choil here for your middle finger, and then you land just right on that jimping that is very nicely cut, very functional. nice and aggressive, but not too aggressive. And we have the same style of jimping here on the back on this smaller titanium backspacer. So overall, very nice high-end overall production. Also nicely finished on the inside. You can see you have a reflective tumbled finish here on the inside of the liners. Very easy to clean out there because we have only a shorter kind of backspacer there. We have internal stop pins that you can see in here. So that's, there's the stop pin, and there's a channel cut into the blade where these stop pins rotate. Free falling ball bearing action. We have a larger kind of accented pivot screw right there that is matte bead blasted in the finish. Large torque set there, and then we have some smaller but same style body screws. The body screws are a little bit proud of the carbon fiber overlays, so they are not flush and not countersunk into the handle, just something to keep in mind. There is absolutely no sharp edge or corner on this knife, just the edge right there. Everything is nicely chamfered and rounded. We also have this cutaway here, which comes in handy when you're deploying the blade, with this super minuscule and very understated flipper tab, which gives this knife a very fast and very modern overall styling. When it's closed, looks a little bit like a fast sports car or a spacecraft or something like that, because you have just this super tiny fin. But deploying the knife with that is absolute no problem, as you have seen here. You have good functional, pretty aggressive jimping. So if you do this for hours on end, you will feel the jimping a little bit in your index finger, but it works every time. Very nicely dialed in detent here on the Viper Blown. You can see that here, sucks it in very well, and just a fun to play with, and such a nice and strong and authoritative flip when you open that knife. Really well done, especially considering the size of that flipper tab, which is just the most minimalist you could actually go. So very nicely done. It's almost a top flipper here, so really, really well done and very nicely executed by Viper Knives with the detent and the execution of that flipper tab. Overall fit and finish nicely centered, maybe a tiny bit to the locking side, but probably also, yeah, I would say a tiny bit to the locking side. Lock up, absolutely no play in any direction. Here we can see the lock up. Nice and solid, pretty early. On the disengaging, you can feel sometimes a slight bit of stickiness. It's not real lock stick, it's just that you feel there is some enhanced contact to the tang of the blade. So it's not a real lock stick. It's always very easy to disengage that lock bar, even if you do it multiple times, that's absolutely no problem. But sometimes you can feel some very slight stickiness to the contact interface between the stainless steel blade and the titanium lock bar. Also nice and generous cutaway, so very easy to go in there and disengage that lock bar, absolutely no problem. You can also do it from the left side like this. Now you heard it maybe, but very, very nicely done. And also the action feels really nice, defined and rich. Still free falling, but it's not a guillotine that will go into the handle there and pop out again. It's still very defined, but very smooth overall. So really well done on action and overall construction here on the Viper Blown. If we take a closer look at the blade here, we can see, of course, it's going to be a fingerprint magnet with that satin finish. We have our standard kind of white lasered in markings, Blown and Viper, made in Maniago, Italy, as well as the Viper logo with the tongue of the snake there. And then here we have the Vox and the steel marking. The marking on this side I don't mind, they are very tastefully done. I'm not the biggest fan of the billboarding on here. I would like to see just a toned down Viper logo here in this area and scratch everything else, maybe right below here on the spine of the blade. But right here in the middle of the blade, I think the logos are slightly overdone on this particular piece. I think it's nicer or slightly more understatedly done here on the key, but still also here I would like to see it slightly smaller and a little bit less billboarded up, but that's certainly a personal preference. The blade itself works very well. You have good belly, you have a nice tip, which is pretty robust, but you still get a good tip to open up packages and things. You have minimalist clip point blade right here. Looks very old style, very old country style, like an older blade from a farmer or something like that. It also reminds me in the overall form factor a little bit of the CKF Vexia, which was also a knife that I was quite interested in. But you have a very, very traditional kind of blade shape that works so well for a variety of uses and makes it a great EDC piece. Full belly, nice tip, good jimping at the top, not overly thick. The cutting edge gets reasonably thin behind the edge. It's actually quite sharp. Could be thinner like most knives, most production knives, but it's absolutely nothing to complain about. It works very, very well in EDC use. And as I said, the handle has a lot of space here. I have small to medium hands, 7.5 sterile glove. If I grip it here in the way it's probably intended to be held, I can very nicely fit all my four fingers on there. If I do a slight foregrip, I have even space for two additional fingers. So even for larger hands, I think the Viper Bologne here will be a great piece. Also, because you get a quite large overall blade in such a slim and very easy to carry package, I think this could be a great gentleman's folder or office carry style knife. Also, very interesting and important part for carry is, of course, your pocket clip. And I think this has changed from the earlier Bologne models. I will inlay a picture that I saw in a video of JT's Knife Life, where he has a very different pocket clip that was like a continuous loop and not like this one here. I think this is greatly improved. There is no interference with that pocket, with that body screw right there. You have a good lip. It's very nice and springy. It has good clearance overall for all the pants you would actually have. And it is a super nice deep carry clip that hides the whole knife in your pocket. So the clip that is on mine Bologne here, I think is very well done and greatly improved from the original one, which you have seen in the overall inlay footage. The knife itself comes in a lot of different varieties. There are blue, gray, and bronze titanium anodized colors available on the titanium, and there is this carbon fiber overlay version. There is also a titanium overlay version, and I believe there are even others. I will inlay a picture where you can see the different options on the Viper Bologne, but certainly a very nice thing on all these Italian makers that they offer a bunch of different options on the handle materials and colors and everything then you can get. I really like that about the Italian makers, and I think the Bologne here by Jesper Voxnes is such a great piece. Great overall size, very nicely compact in this dimension, so not too broad. You can carry a bunch of things in the same pocket without having any issue reaching past the Bologne, because it has a very nice, very forward, very small flipper tab that is not going to cause any issues. No way to cut yourself here on that knife. Also, blade to handle ratio is nicely used up there, so very well in just the overall execution here on the Bologne. If we take a look at some size comparisons, first off we have the Viper Key, which is going to be smaller, blade length is smaller, and also the handle length is going to be quite a bit smaller, so it is on the medium to large end of the size spectrum in my opinion. Let's do some standard kind of size comparisons. Here we have the F95 NL at the top, which is larger, and then we have the Neon Zero at the bottom, which is very, very close. And you know, this is one of my absolute favorite EDC blades. You can see it etched out a slight bit more cutting edge, but size-wise, these are pretty much identical in terms of length. But of course, it is less in terms of width here. If you take a look at these two knives, thickness wise, I believe these will be quite similar. Maybe this is even slightly thicker. Then we have our standard kind of EDC benchmark knives. You have the Paramilitary 3 at the top and the Benchmade Bug Out at the bottom. These are both aftermarket micarta scales, and you can see it's larger than both, but certainly in the overall footprint more along the lines of a Bug Out, just a little bit more slender and a little bit longer overall. Thickness of blade and handle, we can see thicker than a Bug Out in both, and probably handle thickness could be close to a Para 3, so pretty much standard kind of thickness. Blade stock is thinner in the beginning and probably thicker at the tip, so certainly good overall size here on the Bologne. And then I have some other more competitive offerings here. I have the 0609 from ZT, then I have the MDD-K by Wingman EDC, and I have the Protec Malibu as well to show you. And you can see these are knives that are all very much in the same kind of blade length and overall length spectrum. So if you have either one of these, you can kind of guess how large the Bologne is. It is slightly larger than these two at the bottom, and probably about the same as the CT at the top, maybe even a tiny bit larger there. So I hope you get a feel for the size and overall quality of the Viper Bologne. I, for my case, was very pleased with this knife. I think it's a great looking knife. It has a great action, nice and solid lockup. Overall, very interesting options you can get on the cosmetic side of things. The action is very impressive, especially the detent and the deployment with that very tiny flipper tab. You can see free falling, the performance in EDC use with this super useful blade shape is also very well done, and they use a high-end steel with M390 that Cedric and Ada from Gear and Outdoors has also tested. So very nice higher-end knife here from Viper, and the price here is under $200 for everything that you're getting: made in Italy, titanium, carbon fiber, M390, and great clip. Overall, just a very great design by Jesper Voxnes. I think that is certainly a good price for everything that you're getting here, and I would certainly recommend you to check out the Viper Bologne if you like the overall form factor of a longer, more slender style of gentleman or high-end EDC office type carry. I think that would be a great option and a great knife to consider. And I hope you liked this review. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, put them down in the comments and I will answer there as soon as possible. And if you want to get some new knives, check out whitemountainknives.com and use my discount code 7ready to get 10% off at checkout. Also, follow me on Instagram at 7ready_knives_reviews, and consider supporting me on Patreon, where you can pitch in a couple of dollars and get early access to all my videos. Thank you for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.